Hey, what's up guys, welcome back. And yes, I'm not kidding when I say that this software is what you would ever require for all your video needs. As a YouTuber and a regular PC user, I would categorize this as one of the must-have software for your everyday use. And this is the software I just talked about and is called the Wondershare Converter. So once you have launched it, you could see this window with a clean UI. This is definitely a user-friendly software. I'm kind of a first-time user here, but I already feel like I know what is going on in here. That's how user-friendly it is. There is a whole lot of features you could use with this, but I'm gonna start with this video converter tool because it is the primary purpose of this software. You can either import the videos from your PC or load it from available DVD. I'm gonna import this gameplay video I recorded. So it's been imported and you can see the details in here. Right now it's in MOV format and in full HD quality. Now let's say I want to convert it into any other format. For that I just have to go to this section right here. So right in this tab you can choose all the video formats you want to convert your videos to. I can convert it to MP4 or HEVC MP4 or to MOV or any other given formats. This list does have a huge number of formats. 24 video formats to be exact as of now. The 24 formats I mentioned ends here with SWEF. Also, you could optimize your video to be uploaded on these social media platforms. So you got a total of 28 options to convert your videos into, and that's not the end. You can also choose your required video quality under each format. So the level of customization is mind-blowing with this software. Even though I'm a YouTuber and this may be a better option for me, I would always convert all my videos to MP4. I don't care the actual format of the original video, I would always choose MP4 because it is the most compatible video format. Usually people use these converters to convert their videos from MOV to MP4. Some of the video camera outputs would be in MOV format, and if you are a Mac user, you would have come across the MOV file formats than the Windows users. So in short, if you wanna stream your videos to online services or want a more compatible format, you need to convert it to MP4. And this software can do it better because you can not only convert but can also choose the required quality and size as well. I usually go with full HD resolution because nowadays that's the minimum standard quality to upload videos on YouTube. And if you think your options to customize ends with that, you are wrong. Because you can also convert it into audio if you want to. Again, you get multiple formats to choose from with customizable quality. And finally, you can also optimize your videos to be playable in various devices. Let's say you have iPhone XS and if you want a video to be optimized for your device, just tap on this option. My device is Samsung S9, so I would have to choose this option, which is S8. I guess they still haven't updated this section. But I'm pretty sure that this S8 option should be working fine for me. So once that's all set, you could just tap on this convert button. Once you do that, it would start to convert. It may take a little bit of time depending on the performance of your PC. You can also boost your speed, but just be aware that your choice of video formats would be reduced in this turbo mode. But no worries, it still supports all the essential formats, especially the MOV and MP4. But I'm not gonna boost right now because I don't want to use all my PC's power for this conversion process. Now while that's being done, let's go to this next tab which would allow you to download online videos. This is where you really got to be careful. Downloading online videos may not be legal unless it's copyright free. Make sure you have the permission from the content creator. I do use it to download non-copyright music for my videos. The next tab says burn, and as the name suggests, it lets you burn videos or files. You can import videos from your PC and any available DVD folders and burn them to another DVD folder or into an ISO file. If you have installed PC games to your desktop, you must be familiar with ISO files. Now let's move on to the next tab. As the name suggests, you can transfer videos into an Android device, Apple device or other storage devices. I'm not gonna go deeper into how this works, all you gotta do is choose a file and start transferring. So if you think we are about to conclude this tutorial, you are wrong. There is a whole lot you could do with this video converter and this toolbox tab is gonna prove that. I don't want to drag this tutorial much longer, so I'm not gonna explain all of its features. You can check them out yourself once you have downloaded it. The very first tool probably gonna let you fix any errors with metadata of videos. In short, you can edit the name, credits, description, genre or other details of the video. And this VR converter is just another advanced feature you may find cool. You can convert your videos into VR and enjoy them on your VR devices. I'm gonna save this feature for another dedicated video. Now I'm just gonna try and compress a video to see how much space we could save upon a single video. I'm gonna choose this gameplay video for that. The video resolution is full HD and the length is over 7 minutes. But the file size is too large, almost 5 GB. In default, it could reduce the video size to 531 MB without any quality loss as per them. Now let's see how much more size it could cut by keeping the resolution to full HD. And wow, I don't know if I should believe that you can cut the file size of this video from 4.7 GB to just 60 MB. That is actually just 2% of the original size. I'm gonna have to check if it's true. So let's start compressing. So now the compressing is done and probably the conversion process as well. I'm gonna click OK and let's head on to the compressed file. Okay, so the file size is reduced to 317 MB and not 60 MB, but still that means over 90% of the file size is reduced. The important thing is that this video is still in full HD resolution. Now let's play it. Okay, actually you can see the quality is being reduced with the file size. So if you want the original quality and reduce the file size at the same time, you better stick on to the suggested file size before compressing. So the conversion is also done and you get the exact file and quality you asked for. Now I'm gonna show you my favorite feature of this software, and that is this recording tool. If you're a gamer or a YouTuber, you really need this one. You can record your gameplays or even create your own tutorials like this one. You can record full screen or maybe a small portion of your screen. Also, you can choose to record with your desktop audio or your voiceover from the given microphone or both. Again, it doesn't end with that. You can create GIF from your video clips or from photos, burn videos, which we actually covered before. And also cast your videos to bigger screens if you're not satisfied with your PC monitor. So finally, that's the end of it. The main purpose of this software is to convert videos, and this one seems to be the best one at it. I just showed you these other features because I thought before downloading the software, you should be knowing what this can actually do. Talking about the download, if you think you can make use of any of these features, download the software from their official site, videoconverter.wondershare.com. But I would recommend you to use my link in the description so that they would know that you all came to know about this software through my channel. Also, the free trial version would have its own limit. For example, with free trial you can only record videos up to 1 minute length, while with full version you can do unlimited recording. You can even upgrade to full version from their official site. I don't know about you, but I would recommend you to choose this pack so that you could enjoy the software for your lifetime with just a single payment. So with that being said, I'm winding up this video. Give me a thumbs up if you think this video was helpful, but still, if you think that this tutorial video wasn't worth your time, just go on dislike this video. It's your opinion that matters. By the way, I want to thank Wondershare for partnering with me for this video. And I wanna thank all of you for taking your time to stop by this video. As said, if you like the software, don't hesitate and download it right now. So see you guys in the next video, and until then, peace out.